Welcome to Everyday Moodlings. I'm your host, Jeri Parks, and in this video, we're going to do a little compare and contrast on a number of the different crayons that are on the market. We'll call them crayons. They also go by the label of water-soluble oil pastels. So let's look at some of the brands that we are going to talk about. And I'll also kind of share with you which are my favorites. So to do this demonstration, like I said, we're going to use five different types of crayons. The two that are probably most popular in the market right now are the Distressed and the Gelatos. So I have almost the complete set of the Distressed. Now typically I don't end up that enamored with a product that I want every little piece of it, but that did in fact happen with the Distressed crayons. I do really like them, and I did just pick up the three new ones for this year. So I have one set that I do not have, and it's the one that has the lighter, more pastel colors in it, and I will probably eventually get that one as well. I think we're going to work with these darker colors today. Excuse me. And I just have this tin that I throw them all into. I like not having them in their containers. I like to just dig around for them. So those are the Distressed that we're going to work on. I'll talk about the tags here in a moment. And I'll probably keep all of these to one or two colors, so we can kind of see how they work. So these are Gelatos. They have been on the market for a long time. I think, honestly, they're kind of spendy. Not that the Distressed is any cheaper. They're actually pretty much the same. Now, you can actually go and look. You used to be able to. I didn't double check it before I did this video, but you used to be able to go to places like Amazon and look at Faber-Castell and oil pastels or crayons, and you will actually get, there's another set out there that they make that is not under the Gelatos name, and it's actually like half the price. You can't get the variety of colors, but it's a great way to get started. Then we also have these Crayola oil pastels. These are from their portfolio series. These are really, really nice. You can see I've dumped them all together. They start to get a little cross-contaminated, but that doesn't really bother me all that much. These are almost identical to the Faber-Castell, and they are half the price. Now, again, you don't have quite the number of or variety of colors, but I do like this set because the colors are kind of a lot darker than some of the other ones. So I'm just kind of digging around in here to see what colors I want to use. I'm kind of drawn to that one, and I think I want this yellow. The yellow's kind of bright, but I think we'll go with that anyway. So I also wanted to show you a comparison of actually using watercolor crayons. So yes, they do make watercolor crayons. This is a set by Lyra. This is a real nice set to get started with. Again, I should have thought about colors before I opened all these up. We'll go with purple and yellow there. That's a nice combination. Just wanted to show you how the two products kind of differ. And then one of my other favorites is the Prima set. These are really creamy and they're just really nice. I love the colors. So I think I'm gonna go with this one and this like magenta color. I like those two together as well. Again, not nearly the variety of colors as Gelatos or Distressed, but I think they give you enough colors in the box to really get pretty much whatever you want. Okay, so how are we going to test these out? Well, we're going to do it on watercolor paper that I've cut into tags. And then I went ahead and put a little used a stencil and applied some modeling paste. I actually used a light modeling paste. Textured paste is basically the same thing if you have that. What you're looking for is something that's going to create some texture and interest, but is semi-porous. So some acrylic mediums have a glossy finish to them, so they're more of a resist. This particular one has a very matte finish to it. It's actually kind of rough, and it's going to absorb or hold on to some of that color versus resisting it. So the other thing you're going to need is a spray bottle. What we're really going to be talking about in this video is how much movement do you get with these products on a tag with just some water. Let's just see, kind of see what happens. And I did want to note here, I do have a crayons class. I'll put a link for that. And this is part of what we do in that class, to really test it out on different papers, different techniques, and see how each one of them performs. There's a lot to be learned from there. So if I had to pick my two favorite, it would be Prima and Distressed. I find the gelatos to be a little too crumbly, a little too waxy. These two are much more creamy. And the only reason I have so many of the Distressed, well, one, I just really like the formula that he uses. And two, if you've followed me for a while, you know that I kind of like to stick within a single brand if I can. It just makes decision making easier. So that's kind of why I have gravitated towards those. So let's get started then with the Distressed. The Distressed probably are the most pen-like, and I haven't even used that one. How awesome. So I'm just gonna apply a little here and there. I actually love this aged mahogany. It's so pretty. One of the the more unique things about the Tim Holtz product is it does not have the same kind of movement that some of the other crayons have when you get it wet. It kind of wants to stay where it's at, so you have to work, you have to push it where you want it to go. So I'm going to put a paper towel down here just to kind of keep my mess at a minimum. And we're just going to spray it. I want you to see whether or not it's going to run or not. And you can see with the Distressed, it's kind of staying where I've put it on there. Not a whole lot of movement. So now let's go back in here with my favorite applicator, my finger. And you can see now that I've started to move this around, I get good movement and it does dissolve fairly well. All of these crayons will dissolve better on gessoed surfaces than non-gessoed surfaces. So if you're using them and you're like, well, why isn't it dissolving on me? Well, that's because you probably don't have a gessoed surface and it's just not going to dissolve as well for you. So I've kind of moved it around. Now you can see it's almost all dissolved up here. But I still have a lot of places where it's kind of clung to the area. So now I'm just going to get my finger wet and come back in here and kind of pick up that, move that color around a little bit more. And I can actually come in here on just my raised areas and add in some additional color. And it's going to hold that real nicely for me. Now, if I want to, I can actually come back in here and take it away or lighten it up off of that raised area as well. So while his crayons don't really move around a ton when you get them wet, they do have some really interesting properties. Actually, one of the things that I love most about Distressed crayons is how easy they blend. Some of the other ones just don't blend as nice when they're dry. They blend really well when they're wet, not so well when they're dry. So that's actually one of the reasons I ended up purchasing all of them, is that they're just so creamy that they blend really well when they're dry. So it's great for doing edging and not having to get ink out or get everything all wet. So that's a Distress. The colors are great. Obviously, they go with all of his other products really well. Modeling paste holds that color well. You can get some really nice definition on that raised area, but it's not going to move around on you a whole lot when you get it wet, when you just spray it. And even on a gesso surface, doesn't get all that, you don't get all that much movement from it. So let's try our, I'm still bugged by this yellow, so let's pull out this one, and this kind of orangey one instead. Our Crayola. And we're going to do the same thing. Now you'll notice I'm not putting a ton of color on here. Obviously, you can always go back and add more. I kind of like to go light, and then later on, if I need it. Now you can see this activated better than the Distressed. So let's go ahead and kind of move those colors around again. And just working with it here, you can see these colors are dissolving a lot faster, a lot nicer than I got with the Distressed. And my modeling paste is really picking up that color. I love that blue, that's really pretty. So now if I go back on here, obviously I'm going to pick up some of the color. So if you wanted to keep it that same intensity, you can just set it off, let it dry. Again, just like the Distressed, I can come back in here, wet my finger, and blend it. Now, one big difference between this and the Distressed is it just doesn't blend quite as nice dry. I have to work a little harder to kind of get it to blend as nicely. But all in all, it does a good job. Of applying color to a watercolor paper. So let's pull out another tag. So that's our first two. Let's use our gelatos now. One of the first things that you'll notice about the gelatos is they're not as creamy. They are a drier, stiffer product. So actually when you put them down, the color doesn't come out quite as nice or quite as heavy. Kind of have to work at it a little bit more. Okay, let's go ahead and spray this one. And we get just a little bit of color movement, not a whole lot. But by and large, oh, we need to be careful with orange and blue. You can get mud really, really fast. Once you start to blend it, gelatos actually blends nicer than I would say Distressed does. Back up here, add a little bit more color. All of them, you can work on wet paper with them if you want to. orange, while they go well together, when you try to blend those colors together, it's really easy to get mud. So now again, I can come back in here if I want to dry this off and pick up some of this color. I can, or I can let it dry and let it be more intense. It really loves the modeling paste. You can see that. It's really picking it up nicely. But my blue has gotten a little muddied over here. So for blendability, I give the gelatos a big thumbs up when it's wet. Now when it's dry, it typically doesn't blend as well as the other ones. So that's gelatos. Ooh, now we get to use the Prima, one of my favorites. The colors that they chose are just so pretty. They are creamier. You'll notice that they put down quite a bit of color. So we're gonna spray it. Now, with the Prima, you actually get quite a bit of color movement from just spraying it onto watercolor paper. And they actually blend really well, really nicely together. So I know on all of these I've kind of gone back and daubed them up a bit, but I'm gonna leave this one to dry just as it is with that rich, rich color on there. Again, Prima does really well of blending around the edges. And then of course, we have our watercolor crayons, which are really quite different from an oil, water-soluble oil pastel. One of the biggest difference between the two is these are stable when dry. So it's really hard for me to come in here and blend them. They're just not gonna smudge the way the other ones do. A little smudging, but just not nearly as much as the other ones. And with because it's a watercolor, it's very reactive to water, and you can see how quickly that pigment is dissolving on the paper for me. Colors are very blendable, and they catch that water or the modeling paste quite nicely. And I can create a really muted look with them. But I can't come back in here and, I mean I can, because the paper is wet right now, I can come back in here and add in some extra color, but I can't blend it the way I can with the other crayons. The great benefit to a watercolor crayon, a true watercolor crayon, is you get a lot of water movement, a lot of color movement when you use them. A lot more than I would with the distressed. So if you're looking for something that has a lot of movement to it when you get it wet, you're going to want the watercolor crayons. If you want something that kind of sits more still until you move it around, you're going to want something like distressed. Prima is, to me, a really nice middle road option because it does get a lot of movement. It's highly water reactive, yet it's still blendable dry. So you kind of get the best of both worlds there. So those are all five of them that I chose to test. There are other ones on the market. Something becomes popular and then, you know, everyone comes out with it. They are very similar, but they each have their own unique characteristics. What you really need to decide before you make a choice is how much color movement and how much blendability do you want. I like the distressed a lot because they're highly blendable, and that's part of how I use them. Crayolas are great if you're looking to save some money. Prima is just, to me, kind of overall the champion in them. Lots of great color, lots of blendability, and a lot of movement when you add water to it. So unfortunately, gelatos, which are some of the first that came into my stash, are not necessarily my favorite, but you do get, they're very blendable, and they have a wonderful array of colors. So that's a really nice thing about gelatos. Now, you notice when I sprayed them, there wasn't a ton of dripping. So if you've seen those videos where they take gelatos and there's just all, they spray them and it runs down the page, that is done on a gessoed page. These are all just standard watercolor paper, and I did not treat them with gesso at all. So if you want it to really run a lot, you need a sealed surface instead of an absorbent surface. So, but even that, the distress does not move nearly as much as the others. So its characteristic is that it kind of stays put until you tell it where to go. So that sounded kind of bad, didn't it? I love them all, and they are one of my most used tools in my color arsenal. So if you have any questions about the five that I tested, any thoughts about other ones that you've used, please let me know. If you're watching this on YouTube, there'll be a link to the blog. If you are on the blog, obviously you'll get to see the tags, and I'll probably do something with one of them in the post. So until next time, I'm Drew Parks with Everyday Moodlings.